Welcome to this video on database management system. I will explain database schema, DBMS structure with diagram, DBMS roles and responsibilities, and database schema interview questions. Please contact me if you need one-to-one DBMS training. The first topic is database schema. Before we can create a database in the DBMS, we have to do database schema design. Now, a schema defines the data structure for entities and their attributes and the relationships between entities. The schema gives a common understanding of data to all the users. For example, this is a schema that I explained in my SQL queries tutorial. The customer's entity in the entity relationship model becomes the customer's table in the schema. The customer's entity's attributes become the column names in the schema. The relationships in the entity relationship model become the foreign keys. For example, this is a foreign key between orders table customer ID and the customer ID of the customers table. And the actual data will be stored in these tables: customers, orders, order details, etc. In DBMS introduction, you should know about three schema architecture. In database design, it is useful to have three types of schema: conceptual schema, external schema, and physical schema. What I just showed you, the customers and order tables, etc., was an example of a conceptual schema. The conceptual schema gives a high-level structure of the data with entities and relationships. When we have designed the conceptual schema, then we can design multiple external schema for different user groups. The external schema defines the views for different user groups, like one external schema for marketing, another external schema for engineering, another for accounts, and so on. The conceptual schema relies on the physical schema, which defines the physical storage and retrieval of data. The benefit of three schema architecture is that it allows data independence, meaning that changes to one schema do not affect the other schemas. For example, we can change the physical schema without touching the conceptual schema, or we can add another external schema without changing the conceptual schema. Next, in this DBMS tutorial, let us see database design interview questions and answers on database schema. The first question is, what is the difference between external schema and conceptual schema? The difference between external schema and conceptual schema is that one external schema provides a specific view of the database to a single group of users, but the conceptual schema provides a high-level view of the entire database. Another difference is that a single external schema provides a detailed view to the specific user group or application, but the conceptual schema view is independent of any user group or application. Another difference is that an external schema can be complex because it has to satisfy all the requirements of a user group, but the conceptual schema can be simpler because it is at a high level. Next question is, what is the difference between conceptual schema and physical schema? The difference is, the conceptual schema does not show any database technology or implementation details, but the physical schema shows the implementation details like servers, disks, and physical storage structures like files. Another difference is, the conceptual schema is designed using the entity relationship model, but the physical schema is designed using servers, partitions, clustering, and so on. Another difference is, the conceptual schema is used by database developers, but the physical schema is used by database administrator, also called DBA. Next, database design interview question is, what is database latency? Now, data latency in a database system is the time delay between data generation and data availability to the user. Data latency is caused by processing delay, network latency, or any database update operations that may be going on. High data latency may impact decision making based on that data. So one of the responsibilities of database administrator is to minimize data latency by optimizing database performance and improving network connectivity, etc. Next question is, what are the common strategies to optimize a database schema? These include denormalization, meaning combining tables to reduce the joins needed for queries. Indexing, meaning creating indexes on frequently queried columns in a table. Partitioning, meaning the division of a large table into smaller partitions. Each partition can be stored on a separate disk. These partitions can then be read in parallel, which improves the query performance. Caching, which means storing the frequently accessed data in memory. Caching can be done at database level, application level, or query level. And sharding means distributing data across multiple servers to improve performance. Next, let me explain the DBMS structure with diagram. Do you remember from the previous video what is DBMS? DBMS is a software system that provides an interface between the users and the database. I will now explain the structure of DBMS with neat diagram that I have drawn for you. These are the main components of a typical DBMS. So starting from the bottom, data storage component stores the data as tables. It interacts with buffer manager. The buffer manager stores the frequently accessed data pages from the database. The buffer manager keeps track of which pages are in memory, read pages from disk into its buffer cache, and writes the modified pages back to disk. In structure of database management system, the query language engine is the component used by users to get and update the data stored in the database. SQL, meaning structured query language, is commonly used by the users. SQL is handled by the query language engine. Internally, the query language engine uses the query optimization component to optimize the queries for efficiency and response time. Now, in basics of DBMS, you should also know about concurrency control component. It ensures that multiple transactions can execute simultaneously without conflicts. A transaction basically means a unit of work, for example, a payment from one user to another user. And there may be multiple steps in a transaction. The transaction manager ensures that each transaction succeeds or fails as a single unit, thereby keeping the database in a consistent state. In case of power failure or system crash, the recovery manager component can restore the database using the latest backup. After system structure of DBMS, let me explain DBMS roles and responsibilities. The closest to the DBMS is Database Administrator, or DBA. DBA roles and responsibilities are managing and maintaining the databases. Other DBA responsibilities are performance tuning, security, backup, and recovery. The DBA role is very important. The responsibilities of DBA include the database administrator functions and other responsibilities not assigned to any other role. Database developer designs and builds databases. Database developer creates tables, defines relationships between tables, and writes stored procedures and functions for other user roles. Other user roles include data analyst, who analyzes data in databases and creates reports and visualizations based on that data. Business analyst works with business users to understand their data requirements and provides inputs to the database developer, who then creates the relational data models like entity relationship models and the schema. Application developer designs and builds applications that get the data and store the manipulated data in one or multiple databases. An end user accesses the databases using SQL queries or applications. I hope that you learned new DBMS basics from my DBMS notes, like DBMS database system structure and components of database system architecture. I explained the roles of DBA, meaning roles of database administrator. If you understand my DBMS explanation, please like these DBMS tutorials for beginners. In the next video, I will explain relational algebra, relational calculus, enhanced entity relationship model, and other topics. Please view this complete database management system full course in the database management system in English playlist. Thank you.